Yeah. Good evening, everyone, and welcome to our high school marching band indoor concert. Please ask that everyone turn off any cell phones or any devices that would make noise, and enjoy the concert. Just in case you have not been to one of our indoor marching shows, I'm just going to do a little explanation of what this concert is. It's not a lot of marching, actually. It's just it's an opportunity for us in a concert setting to showcase our marching band and what they've done this year, both through our marching band and also our pep band, which is more active here in the fall. The visual portion of our concert is we do have a couple of the songs of the flags come out, but primarily our marching band itself is focusing on just playing the tunes. And the first portion of the concert is mostly music that we play if you go to a volleyball game, a football game, and in the near future, basketball games. This is the music that we play for that. We'll have a few of the selections with just the band. The color guard will come out for Sweet Caroline. And at the end, we will have our marching show that we put together with along with the school song. Just a couple little things, being I have all the parents here. Next week with pep bands, once I know for sure on different dates and times, I will be sending out that information when I have that. We'll start off with one of our pep band tunes here, Bad Romance.
Thank you.
wanted to just point out that a couple of our last songs have become some of our favorite pep band songs, but they actually started out as some of our marching songs. Impression that I get, I cannot remember. I don't think any of them played that for their marching song, even the seniors when they were freshmen. I think that was a little bit before their time, but that quickly became one of our favorite pep band songs. And then Shut Up and Dance was actually our marching song from last year. And we incorporated the dance move back in. We had a little bit of time at the end of last week. We got all the freshmen caught up to speed, got everyone the movement learned and everything. We tried the spin that we tried at one point, but we discovered that with everyone so close together that we're gonna probably have a couple bloody noses and things like that. So we decided not to do the spin. This year, before I forget, I'd like to acknowledge a few people. First off, Janice Seachlug and Katie Gillette. Without them, we would honestly not have a color guard. They take all of that and run with it. We work together really well and get our shows together. I don't have to worry about that visual part because they have it taken care of, and it just really enhances our band. So let's give them a round of applause. And then I'd like to, before I forget also, with what being we're talking, we just talked about Color Guard, they're currently doing, finishing up a fundraiser right now. So if you are interested in fudge or garden flags, I think Jim Seachlog has some order forms. He'll be available somewhere over here, I think, once we're done. So if you are interested in getting some fudge or some lawn flags, go talk to him. Other people that I need to thank would be all the band parents that volunteer to come to our parades. Again, without them, it's already a little bit of chaos getting ready for a parade or getting things taken off for a parade. If you've ever been there and experienced that, it is a little bit of chaos. It would be even more so if I did not have those volunteers. Thank you so much to those people who volunteer for that. And just all band parents, everyone who gets their kids up in the morning to do our 7 a.m. rehearsals, just all the support that our kids receive. Thank you for that. And then lastly, our administration, the teachers here, our custodial staff, for just the continuing support, getting everything ready for us so that we can be as successful as possible. Our marching season this year was very successful. We had two competition parades that we participated in. We first did Prairie Days like every year during the fair week, and we had a very successful parade there. And then in our first competition was Turkey Days, and we received second place in our class. And we had a little time to continue to better ourselves. We usually have a week off before we have Tri-State. And this year in Tri-State, people keep on asking, like, oh, is this the first time we've gotten first place? Actually, no. In the past 4 years, we have received first place in Tri-State the last 3 out of the 4 years. So congratulations. Unfortunately, because of weather and things, we did not go to Sioux Falls this year, but I'm sure they would have done very, very well, and we'll get back at it next year and try to take first there also. Our marching song this year is The Greatest Show. You'll see a lot of that theme through our color guard. We'll just end with the school song. Lastly, in the very end of the concert, everyone who's sitting over here, you'll need to make sure you get out of your seats pretty quickly because we will be doing a picture right there. Parents, if you'd like to snap a picture of your the full band, you can definitely do that. Once that is done, if you want to get individual pictures, that's fine. The last thing I want to remind people is everyone owns their marching shoes. So today, when we're done with our marching shoes, those can go home. Then they're not just sitting around in the band and get lost in things. So just a reminder to everybody, you just bring your band shoes home today. All right, I think that is it. I think our color guard is ready, so we'll continue our marching concert.
probably fine.